luxuries do depend on person to person. Like, for example, a student having a bike, is it a comfort or a luxury? A student having a bike, is it a comfort or a luxury? On the same hand, a student doing a part-time job along with his studies, so there it becomes a necessity but not a luxury or a comfort. So it depends upon the nature and the situation. The definition do differ, but here the concept is, in the case of necessities, the demand is inelastic. In the case of comfort and luxury, the demand is inelastic. What do you mean by elastic and inelastic? Elastic is whatever may be the price, it doesn't change. Inelastic refer to if the price comes down, the demand goes up, and if the prices increase, the demand reduces. So therefore, we say for comforts and luxuries, the demand is inelastic. For necessities, it is elastic. I'm telling reverse, sorry. For comforts and luxuries, it is elastic. For necessities, it is inelastic. The demand doesn't differ, whatever may be the price. The demand differs in the case of comforts and luxuries if there is increase or decrease in the prices. So this is what nature of the product. The first point is products are classified into three: necessities, comforts, and luxuries. For necessities, it is inelastic. For comforts and luxuries, it is elastic. An example of this is, you can even give a student having a bike may be a comfort or luxury, but a student doing the job along with his studies would be a necessity. Is that clear? So this is all about the nature of the product and influencing factor influencing elasticity of demand. Now going to the time frame. A time frame is nothing but availability of time. If there is much availability of time, example, bringing vegetables from Raitu Bazaar is economical or cheaper in comparison with if you go and buy the nearby outlet. But what if there is no time frame at all? So availability of time to take the buying decision as well as commutation plays a very important role in elasticity of demand. So if there is no time frame, then definitely we will go and buy nearby, whatever may be the price. Now, number of alternative uses, the third factor that influencing. So this will exactly give an example of power, that is electricity. So electricity is used in multipurpose. If as many as alternative uses we use, then it becomes inelastic. If there are no much alternative uses, it is elastic. So like, for example, power consumption, right from the day we start with owning our geyser till we sleep with our AC, we consume electricity. So if the prices of electricity do go up, we don't bother much. Why? Because our life runs with a power, and there are multiple purposes of using that particular electricity or power what we purchase. So therefore, it's very important that how many number of alternative uses they are. The number increases, it becomes more inelastic. If there are only few or less, then it is elastic. Like, for example, before the Telangana government, we used to have so many power cuts, isn't it? That is, at the summer, we used to have every 2 hours, like there are time slots that have been given for the power cut. But from since we have been purchasing from the other states, the prices went up. But did the consumption come down? It's a question, Anna. If the prices of power increased, did the consumption come down? Is it possible to reduce the consumption?
No, ma'am.
No. So, yeah, so therefore, we say that the more number of alternate uses, the more it is inelastic. The degree of postponement, the fourth factor. The fourth factor, if there is possibility of postponement, then we can postpone when the prices have come down. Like, example, you can give in the case of gold. Gold, if prices are high, but there is a marriage that need to be conducted, we can't postpone the purchase. But if it is not such, it's just for an investment, then we can wait till the prices come down and buy the time the prices come down. So the degree of postponement, is it possible to postpone? Then it is elastic. If it's not possible as there is an urgency in purchase, then it is inelastic. Now going to the taste and preferences of the consumers. So taste and preferences plays a very important role. If the consumers are very particular, the elasticity is inelastic. If the consumers are not much particular about the brand, about the tastes and the preferences, then it is elastic. Like we see so many don't compromise with even the concept of toothpaste that we use. But normally we don't taste the paste, but still we observe so many people who doesn't compromise with the paste they use. And how about the coffee, the tea powder that they use, the soap they use, the shampoo they use? We find so many loyal consumers who never change their brand and the manufacturer. What if the prices go up also? So if the consumers are very particular, then it is inelastic. If the consumers are not that particular about the preferences and tastes, then it is elastic. And the coming to the availability of close substitutes, if there is an availability of substitutes, then it is elastic. If there is no availability of substitute, then we can say it is inelastic. Can you name a product where there is no close substitute to it? We have to for sure buy the same product. There is no substitute for it. Any example? You know what you mean by substitutes by this time, isn't it?
Petrol, ma'am.
Yeah, very good, Nana. And even I told for petrol, it is inelastic, isn't it? Very good example. There is no substitute for petrol. We have electric, but I don't think we find much electric bikes or electric cars in India still now. So there is, we can't say that there is substitute, isn't it? So petrol is a good example. Or even commuting in train. We don't have any compensatory or substitute for train, isn't it? Want to travel in train? We have only Central Railways, pay the price, whatever the Central Railways pay. Or the third example we can give is gold, isn't it? Is there any substitute for the precious yellow metal in India? Don't say platinum. Is platinum a close substitute to gold?
No, ma'am, it's gold.
It's not at all, isn't it? There is no substitute for gold. So for such, if there are more substitutes, it is elastic. If there are no substitutes at all, then it would be, yes, if there are substitutes, it is
elastic.
Yeah. And if there are no substitutes, it would be inelastic. Whatever may be the price, people are forced to purchase whatever may be the price of that particular product. In case of level of prices, so what do you mean by in case of level of prices? If the prices are too high and if the prices are too low, the prices are too high, such as platinum, diamonds, if the prices go up also, the demand is inelastic. And the too low, such as the price of a salt, also people don't bother, it would be inelastic. Is that clear? So in case of level of prices, constitute two. One is when the prices are too high, example diamond and platinum, and if prices are too low, example salt, then the demand would be inelastic. Then availability of subsidies. So subsidies refer to the government provides subsidies, isn't it? As I said, if you are an SEZ, that is special economic zone, or if you are in EOU, export-oriented unit, government provides many subsidies, isn't it? So such as concession rate of interest, no tax that need to be paid, there the demand would be inelastic and vice versa. The next one is expectation of prices. Prices refer to, if you have an information that the prices are going to go still up, if the prices are currently up also, people buy. Especially this would be in the case of necessities such as rice and so on. If you get an information that the prices of onions or rice is going to be high, though the prices are high, people still buy in an expectation that they may be still costlier in the future. So that's what very important, future expectations of prices. Next, coming to the 10th point, durability. What do you mean by durability? There are two types of goods in this concept, perishable goods and durable goods. So durability is referring to goods that can be used for number of times, such as an AC, fridge, computer or a laptop and so on, which will be used for many number of times. So such is elastic. For perishable, what do you mean by perishable? Such as milk, vegetables, fruits and flowers. For that type of goods, it is inelastic. Is that clear? So durable goods, it is elastic. For perishable goods, it is inelastic. That we don't stop buying milk if the prices go up. Why? Because it's a matter of fuel, which the utility goes on once you consume it. So therefore, the next factor is whether it's a durable good or perishable good. Write in the brackets in the notes, durable or perishable. In government policies, so government policies are also very important in the case of factors influencing elasticity of demand. Like for example, cylinders, subsidy also the same concept comes. Or if the government is very stringent in its policies, very strict, where you can't go beyond it, in such case, it would be inelastic. If the government is not that strict, where it is not able to control black marketing, where it's not able to control black stocking, in such situation, it would be elastic. Is that clear? Like how the government is not able to control the vaccines as well as the injections that are required for COVID. So though there are many measures that are being taken, is black marketing still going on in the market or not? Do you think our government is
yes,
very
strong?
Do you think our government is still
not for vaccine, for
vaccine dorkatled kada?
For vaccine also it is going on, ma'am.
Black marketing refer to purchase, selling at a very high prices, isn't it? I heard Remdesivir is being sold at 35,000 as the cost is just 3,500. It's being sold.
Yes, ma'am. The demand is also very high.
Very high. So this is what the situation outside. So if the government can strictly control, such doesn't happen in US, isn't it? We never heard of such situation at all. And how come even below 18 are also able to get the vaccine there? So there all the policies are systemized and no concept of black marketing or no concept of selling the products in black do happen. Why? Because there the government is different. The policies are different. And I think you are aware of that United States of America, everyone is getting vaccinated without any these all, that is age of 18 and so on, isn't it? Above 18 to till all, everyone is getting vaccinated without any disturbances, not like in India, isn't it? Like now the situation is very horrible that people are not able to get their second dose. First dose was not that difficulty, but now second dose, the situation is very horrible outside. So this is all happening because no proper control. And we are able to hear many rumors that the government is selling the Covaxin outside at a higher rates where it has given to other states and we are getting from Covishield from outside. So all such rumors are, we actually don't know what is the fact, but this, and even we are getting so many from other outside countries also. So the management is not proper in country. Definitely this do happen. Now coming to the next one, in case of complementary and joint goods, so it would be negative. In case of complements and joint goods, it's not direct demand, it's derived demand. So the demand depends upon the main product. So in such case, it is inelastic. So there are 12 factors that influence the elasticity of demand. So you need to write these 12 points, explain with the side headings. It's not just writing the side headings in the case of elasticity of demand. Is it clear, Nana? 12 points?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. And now, significance is the next point. So, significance, we have only 4 points. You can add on more if you want, once you know the concept. But here the significance of elasticity is helping in five areas is what given in the Arishri. So the first one is to decide prices of factors of production. Why? Because to decide the price, elasticity plays a very important role. Why? Because apart from price, there are other 8 factors, but the price is the first main thing, which do have high impact on quantity demanded. So price ki entama, what are the other factors that are involved to decide the price? Factors of production. What is the cost of labor? What is the cost of land? What is the cost of capital? What is the cost of organization? What is the cost of technology to decide the price of particular product? So elasticity plays a very important role. Elasticity of price helps us to what percentage of increase in price have what percentage of decrease in demand. So then we can decide we have to invest only this much in land. We have to invest only this much in labor. We can invest only this much in capital. So an idea of factors of production gets only once we know the elasticity of demand. So production is equal to function of L1, L2, COT. So this we go in unit 3, what it does, what it means and so on. So as of now, just remember, what do you mean by a production function? So factors of production constituting 5, L1 refer to land, L2 refer to labor, C is capital, O is organization, T is technology. Organization is nothing but providing everything at right time, at right place, which is done by the management. So to decide the factors of production, elasticity is important. The second is as well, price fixations. The third one is government policies. So if in the case of necessities, the government enters into. In the case of imports, the government enters in order to control all, such as tax policies, that is GST, and raising bank deposits, public utilities, revaluation and devaluation of currency, and formation of government policies. So elasticity plays a very important role in all these factors. You know, what do you mean by tax policy? Tax classified into direct and indirect. Direct we have income tax, wealth tax. Indirect we have GST and customs. So frame policies in these areas, we need to know what is elasticity. To control imports, we have to even know what is elasticity. Raising bank deposits also. These are all which we have studied in money supply and inflation. Devaluation or revaluation of currencies, increase and decrease in currency. A formation of government policies are the areas where we apply the concept of elasticity. Now the next one is demand forecasting. This is what the next concept that we have in unit 2. Demand forecasting refer to estimation of future sales. It is how many units will it be able to sell in the coming year, so that you plan all factors of production. That is possible in elasticity, because once you know what is the impact of prices and change in demand, you can definitely plan for your production, planning the level of production. So these are the 6 points of significance which is there in Arishri. Elasticity, the total concept is there in Arishri Nanu. So you were confirmed that the book is open in Google, isn't it? Did you refer, Nana, all of you? Did you open the book? Anyone opened the book of Arishri in the Google?
I opened.
Yes? Could you find the book?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So only one have tried, not all?
The third you can take in library, ma'am, after
college. Elthunar, nana, college ke elthunar, amiru, books ke?
No, ma'am. After it opens for months.
So the next concept is law of demand. Factors determine demand we have done now. The next concept is law of demand. Okay. The last concept in unit 1, unit 2 part A is demand and demand analysis. So what do you mean by demand? So before going to law of demand, we need to know what do you mean by demand. So demand, when we say demand, There are three conditions that need to be satisfied whether to name a particular product as a demand or not. What are the three? The first one is need or desire. Okay, each and every consumer need to have a need or desire to purchase the product. The next one is willingness. What do you mean by willingness? The need and desire should lead to willingness. We have so many needs, we have so many desires, but do we really willing to buy that product is what very important. So if this is also satisfied, the last one is whether you have a capacity or ability to pay the price of it. Once you have all the three, then only we say that the product is a demand. If any one condition is not satisfied, we don't mean that the product has a demand. So each and every product would be counted whether it has a demand or not when these three conditions satisfy. The first one is need or desire, followed by willingness, and the last one is ability to pay. When you have ability to pay, then only we say, like each and everyone wants or desires to buy a Benz or a BMW. But the count of a demand would be estimated only when you have ability to pay. That's what very important to estimate a particular demand of a product. So this is all about demand and the three conditions of demand. Now going to the law of demand. So what does law of demand states? The law of demand states when other conditions remaining the same, when the prices come down, the demand goes up, and when the prices goes up, the demands come down. So this is what the law of demand states. That what do you mean by other things remaining the same? I mean here all the determinants of demand are same. There is no change except price. The other determinants of demand have no change. Then the law of demand says that inverse relationship between price and quantity demanded. If you can see the graph, you can clearly see when it is a U-shaped sloping from left to right. Why is it sloping left to right in a U-shape? Why? Because when the prices are P1, the quantity is only, when the prices are P, the quantity is only Q. When the prices have fallen to P1, the quantity have increased from Q to Q1. So this is about law of demand, which states that inverse relationship between price and sales, the price and quantity demanded. But we have to be very sure that the other things remaining the same. And what do you mean by other things remaining the same here? Anyone?
The determinants should be same.
Yeah, there should be no change in other determinants. There shouldn't be any change in prices of Patanjali or prices of Colgate. There shouldn't be any change in prices of Patanjali or prices of Colgate. That is known as other things remaining the same. That is, there is no change in other factors of determinants of demand. The price goes up, the quantity comes down, and vice versa. So this is what the concept of law of demand states. Let us see its exceptions. There are four exceptions in law of demand. What are the four exceptions? Is first one is where there is a shortage of necessity feared. Shortage of necessities, as I said, for necessities, is the demand elastic or inelastic? Nana, any one of you? For necessities, is the demand elastic or inelastic? What are necessities?
Elastic or inelastic, ma'am, for necessities.
What are necessities, I said? What do you mean by necessities?
Shelter, water.
Oh, like food, yeah. Water,
food,
milk.
Yeah, food, shelter, food, water, clothing. So these are the things that have the
inelastic.
Inelastic, isn't it? So where there is a shortage of necessity fear, people do still buy if the prices are high. Example, rice. Example, food, which is a staple food. Rice is a staple food of Indian, especially in South India, isn't it? So if in such situation, if the prices go up, still we purchase more. So exceptions refer to, these are the four points which are exceptional in law of demand. Law of demand says prices go up, quantity comes down. But here if the prices go up, they still buy more because they fear there may be more shortage in the future. So they buy more. Did you get it, Nana? The first exception? Yeah, Nana.
Yes, ma'am.